Hi everyone, how's it going? Serge, Siou here, and welcome to macStudioA. Before starting, I'd like to give a very special thank you for all condolences left on my previous video about why I haven't posted for a while. I would also like to give my sincere condolences for all the people that shared the loss of their loved ones. Your words have touched me in a tremendous way. Thank you so much for your kind words. Continuing on, in this episode, I'll go through the process of creating an adjustment layer in Apple Motion and demonstrate how to use it in Final Cut Pro 10.4 to showing how the reveal effect or transition shown was created. We've got a lot to cover, so let's get started. My workflow when editing footage in Final Cut Pro 10 usually involves applying an adjustment layer. The best way to describe what's an adjustment layer is as follows. Any effects placed on an adjustment layer affects all clips below it. For example, let's say we want to apply the same effects to various clips on the timeline. Instead of editing each individual clips, we just need to add an adjustment layer above all the clips. As you can see, adding relevant effects on the adjustment layer affects all the clips below it. I find this very useful when color grading footage in post, a great time saver. Unfortunately, Final Cut Pro 10 doesn't include an adjustment layer, but creating one is super easy to do, provided you have Apple Motion. Therefore, assuming you have Apple Motion, let's create an adjustment layer. Open Motion, then click on the Final Cut title icon. While not very important, adjust preset and frame rate based on your typical project and select a duration of say 30 seconds. This can always be changed in Final Cut Pro 10. Then click the Open button. Once opened, simply click on the Type Text Here layer and delete it. Believe it or not, but that's all there is in creating an adjustment layer in Motion. Now, simply save as with an appropriate name, like Adjustment Layer, and optionally create or use a titles category where you want the adjustment layer to be located in Final Cut Pro 10. I'll just create one called macStudioA. Then click on the Publish button and close Motion. Now, with Final Cut Pro opened, let's see this adjustment layer in action. But first, when recording videos on my Canon Rebel SL2, also known as the 200D, I normally create a custom flat or raw picture style. In summary, what this means is that I'm capturing footage at a higher dynamic range by dialing down the sharpness, contrast, and saturation all the way down as shown. As you can see, the clip on the timeline doesn't look very appealing. In fact, it looks terrible, or basically flat. Let's add an adjustment layer created earlier in Motion above the clip and use it to color grade the footage below. As you'll remember, it was saved in the titles browser under the category of macStudioA. Therefore, with the adjustment layer selected, I'll just decrease the duration for rendering purposes. There's no steadfast techniques or methods in color correction or grading a particular clip. It just has to do with plenty of practice and what looks good to you and what type of look you're going for. Therefore, with the adjustment layer selected, click on the enhancement pop-up menu and select the balance color effect, which automatically adjusts the shadows, highlights, and contrast. Next, and still with the adjustment layer selected, let's work on the overall color grading of the clip. Click on the color inspector icon shown here, and from the color wheels, adjust the shadows, highlights, and midtones accordingly while watching the vector scopes. Adjust the shadows where the longest peak on the Luma and RGB Parade vector scopes are pretty close to zero, highlights close to 100 and mid-tones about 75. That's my particular preference. Just remember, increasing the highlights too much above 100 or the shadows lower than zero may cause your clip to become grainy or the colors crushed. If you want to see a more detailed color grading episode, let me know in the comments below. As you can see, the before and after footage is noticeably better. At this point, this is where I find using an adjustment layer indispensable. Let me explain. I can now duplicate the color graded adjustment layer and apply different looks to them. Quick tip. Holding down the Option key while dragging the color graded adjustment layer anywhere duplicates it. Now, on each of the duplicated adjustment layers, I'll very quickly apply different effects to see which looks good, as shown. Disable the adjustment layers not needed and simply drag the one you want to use over the entire clip, as shown. All this was done without editing or touching the original primary clip on the timeline. I'll now show how the reveal effect shown on the intro was created. The first thing I'll do is use the blade tool to split the clip at an arbitrary section and then duplicate the selected clip by simply holding down the Option key and drag it above the adjustment layer. Now, select the duplicated clip and add the draw mask effect onto it. Reduce the view to say 25% and click here to add the first point. Now, while holding down the Shift key, add the second point. Holding down the Shift key basically allows for a straight line to be connected between two points. Continue holding down the Shift key to add the other two points. Release the Shift key and click on the starting point to complete drawing the mask. As you can see, dragging the vertical line shown here towards the right or left reveals the color graded clip below it. Okay, let's keyframe the mask to animate it. Therefore, skim to the point where you want to start the animation and click on the control point shown here to begin keyframing the mask. Now, on the selected clip, move the playhead to a point where you want the animation to end. Then, drag the left vertical mask line towards the right until the entire color graded clip is visible. And as you can see, when playing the clip, the reveal effect is shown. Let's add some music and voila, done like dinner. Guys, please understand, by no means am I an expert in what I'm showing in this videography series. The methods, tips and techniques used in my workflow is what I've learned and tested. One thing I've found out for sure, in order to get better at videography or cinematography, one has to practice, practice, practice. It's a never-ending learning process in which I hope I can convey what I've learned to you and in the process hope that you can learn something from it. If you have any comments or suggestions related to this videography series, or if you have any questions related to this particular episode, please leave them in the comments below. Also, if you liked this video, please smash that thumbs up button, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already done so, and don't forget to hit that bell icon to be notified of the next episode. Thanks for watching, and see you soon.